Jets were introduced to this sellout crowd, and it's a roar that could be heard across the river in Manhattan.
Goddamn Patriots.
They're set to go as their Jets will match up with Tom Brady and the New England Patriots.
Let's see what you could do. You ain't got. Say less. Really? Something wrong with my mic, man.
Now a run. This is Bilal Powell. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there and you throw it again.
You hear me now?
Throw it again, then you come with a big punch later. Right. Maybe they're just trying to set him up.
On second down, here's McCown. Left side complete, Safarian Jenkins. Yeah. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there? Freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
An early test, 2 plays in. This is 3rd and 2. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he's gonna have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Give him 12 yards there, and the Jets have a first. It was just 3rd down and short, but he bit off a little extra.
I would say way more than he could chew, but he chewed up all that yardage in a big way. And that, to me, that was a combination of offensive line, stacked defense, and they handled it, okay? They got the leverage, they got the blocking angles, and opened up a nice crease. And once you get past that first wave, there's room to run.
That's just the 3rd play from scrimmage. They wanted to avoid that 3 and out. They did. And that one results in 35 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll take this inside the 20 down to the 18. Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Here's McCown. Completes it to Powell. Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. He did everything but get him in the end zone there, but now they're set up. Golden opportunity. Strong opening drive, and they're knocking on the door.
And the way that they did it, now look where they are on the field, right? This is naturally set up for a running play, isn't it? But with his ability to throw the football, his accuracy on this drive, you might want to think about a pass play in this situation.
Interesting. Time to find out.
Dog, throw the ball. Shit.
Set back at the 9-yard line.
Damn.
Well, if you're going to throw the ball on 1st and goal from the 2, the worst thing that should result is an incompletion for you offensively. For Brandon, this is a different type of football. Back in my day, 1st and goal from the 2, a lot of big people with big neck rolls, they were on the field trying to ram it into the end zone.
Here we go now.
McCown throwing on 2nd. Escaping the pressure right.
Wow. What the fuck? Thanks.
And then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts the defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
He's got it, and the Jets lead 7-0. Captain Zero out now as he'll kick this one away.
What happened?
Here's Matthew Slater to return it.
Yeah.
Take this across the 25, couple extra yards up to the 27.
It's like my favorite uniform now.
Yeah, that uniform is sick, dude. Every team.
Yep. Let's see.
Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And he'll get about three here as he's out to the 30.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Again, it's Lewis.
Damn, nice run. Shit.
That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Brady gives this one to Lewis.
Damn.
About 5 yards almost. Out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
That I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're gonna get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Exactly.
Way easier.
Fuck. Yeah, almost.
Quite intercepted. Zone coverage, free safety was there. Couldn't come up with it, and now it's fourth down. On fourth down, on now is the lefty Ryan Allen to punt. Back deep, Jalen Marshall.
Wow. Holy shit. Oh. Yo. I've never seen nobody try to do that before. Wow.
Coming up on their second drive of the game, had the touchdown last time. Now they have the football back, chance to really seize early momentum.
Feels to me like they had a really excellent week of practice, that it all came together, but I'll bet you it got galvanized in the locker room in pregame. Somehow I think the head coach, his oratorical skills were on point.
McCown now on first down. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And a big hit at the end of that one. He's knocked down hard.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
And they'll go on the ground.
Come on.
To the 32, brought down there.
Fucking holes be closing so fast.
Gives him a new set of downs.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
First and 10, here's McCown.
Throw the ball, what the fuck, throw it!
Sometimes I watch fans and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled, quarterback was hit.
Throw.
Wow.
Intercepted.